everyone, my name is Molly. Welcome to the Coastal Watershed Council virtual tour, What Makes a River Healthy? For this virtual tour, you will need paper and pencil. If you need those, go ahead and pause the video and then come back. Okay, let's take a trip back in time. This is a historical photo of the San Lorenzo River. Looks a little bit different, doesn't it, from today? Things have changed over time. There seems to be less trees nowadays, right? Well, now there's a reason for that. Way back in 1955, there was a flood that flooded downtown Santa Cruz, and a lot of buildings got destroyed. And people decided that we needed to stop floods from happening. And one of the ways to do that was to create a barrier between downtown Santa Cruz and the San Lorenzo River. So people removed the trees, removed the plants that were along the river, and constructed a barrier along the river that would stop the water from rising up so high. And because of that, the river is not as healthy as it was before. Okay, everyone, so we're here in downtown Santa Cruz, and we're standing on a bridge looking down at the San Lorenzo River. Now, 122 bird species rely upon this river. Fish, like steelhead trout, rely upon this river. And little bugs called benthic macro invertebrates that live inside the water depend upon the San Lorenzo River. So let's take a look around. What do you notice about the river that makes it healthy? Okay, let's share. Write or tell someone what you noticed that makes the river healthy. Okay, now let's talk to an expert. Here's Whitney. She's a river scientist.
Part of having a healthy river ecosystem involves having a healthy stream bank system. So what we want to see when we have a healthy riverbank is we want lots of natural vegetation. We want big trees like this arroyo willow. We also want tule and different kinds of filter plants that help filter pollution and sediment as it comes down the riverbank.
Let's pause for a second. What did we learn from Whitney? We learned that plants and trees along the banks of the river create habitat and help filter out pollution. When it rains a lot here during the winter, we might get floods. Now, that water is great. We want that water. But the thing is, water has the power to erode away our stream banks. Observe. What do you notice about the stream bank? Awesome. So now let's share. Write down or tell someone, what did you notice? Noticed how the stream bank, the soil, had fallen into the river. So that's erosion. Erosion is the movement of sediment, sand or soil, from one place to another. So why does erosion matter? Which river looks healthier? This one? Or this one? So you probably said the first one, right? The water looks clear. So let's think. Why is clear water better for the plants and animals? So one reason why clear water is important is that it makes it easier for steelhead trout and other wildlife living in the river to see their prey and to see their predators. Now, knowing that erosion should be stopped and that clear water is important, let's think, what might stop erosion from happening? Go ahead and share with someone else or write down your ideas. Best things we can do to stop erosion is to plant native plants. Their roots help hold the soil together and stop the soil from moving into the river.
Just downstream from here, the Coastal Watershed Council is working on improving a section of stream bank habitat. Let's go check it out.
Thanks, Whitney. Well, it was great to explore with you today. You can find other virtual tours like the River Health Day one that Whitney was talking about at our website, coastal-watershed.org. Thanks, everyone. I'll see you later.